हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 6 एंटाइटल्ड एज पोएट्स एंड पैनकेक्स। ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू रीड द फैक्ट्स रिटन अबाउट द ऑथर। द नेम ऑफ द ऑथर इज अशोका मित्रन। अशोका मित्रन इज एन इंडियन ऑथर। So let's read the facts written about Ashoka Mitran. Ashoka Mitran, a Tamil writer. Ashoka Mitran was born in the year of 1931. Ashoka Mitran, a Tamil writer, recounts his years at Gemini Studios. Recounts stands for here, remembers again, recollects, recounts, recollects, or you say remember something again. Remember past experiences, past incidents again. A Tamil writer, Ashoka Mitran, a Tamil writer, recounts his years at Gemini Studios in his book My Years with Boss. What is the name of the book? My Years with Boss, which talks of the influence of movies on every aspect of life in India. The book written by Ashoka Mitran, namely My Years with Boss, talks about the influence of movies. In his book My Years with Boss, Ashoka Mitran has described all the facts, indicating how the movies used to influence every aspect of life in India in the past days. Okay, especially in those days when the film industries were very few in number. So Ashoka Mitran, who used to work at the Gemini Studio in Madras. Okay, again remembers the same days after leaving his job from there, after getting retirement from there, and he writes a book. The name of the book is My Years with Boss. So in his book My Years with Boss, he writes maximum those things which he had experienced during his services at Gemini Studios. The Gemini Studios located in Chennai, nowadays it is known as Chennai, but erstwhile it was known as Madras. The Gemini Studios located in Chennai was set up in 1940. Just 7 years back, before getting independence. The Gemini Studios located in Chennai was set up in 1940. The Gemini Studios was established in the year of 1940 in the city Chennai. It was one of the most influential film producing organizations of India in the early days of Indian filmmaking. It was the beginning of the film industry. So in the beginning days of the film industries, film producing organizations, Gemini Studio had got its popularity, and it had become one of the most influential film producing organizations of India in the early days of Indian filmmaking. No other studio had been so much popular as the Gemini Studio. It had got much popularity. Its founder was S.S. Vasan. You may get these all things as the introductory part of this chapter also. Who was the founder, who was the director of the Gemini Studio? S. S. Watson. The duty of Asoka Mitran in Gemini Studio was to cut out newspaper clippings on a wide variety of subjects and store them in files. Asoka Mitran had been appointed at the Gemini Studio to cut out newspaper, important newspaper clippings. The word clipping stands for here. The word clipping stands for here. Small sized scripts. Okay. Small sized scripts. Important articles, important incidents or any other important things. On a wide variety of subjects and store them in files. So Asoka Mitran had got his appointment there at the Gemini Studios, okay, as a newspaper clippings cutter or collector. He used to sit in his place and tear out the important parts of the newspaper written on a different kind of subjects, and also he used to also store them all in different files. Asoka Mitran ka jo karya tha, Asoka Mitran jo Gemini Studio mein jo kaam kiya karta tha, bada hi sadhan sa kaam tha. The duty of Asoka Mitran Gemini Studio में सबका मित्रन का जो कर्तव्य था, जो कार्य था, जो उसको काम मिला हुआ था, वह था कि विभिन्न प्रकार के विषयों के ऊपर लिखे हुए जो भी लेख होते थे, अन्य कोई विषय पर कोई इम्पोर्टेंट सी कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन लिखी होती थी किसी घटना पर आधारित, उन सभी पर्चियों को न्यूज़पेपर में से उखाड़ना फाड़ना और उनको फाइल में रख लेना, जमा कर लेना. मैनी ऑफ दीज हैड टू बी रिटन आउट बाई हैंड इन दोज डेज. मैनी ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट आर्टिकल्स वर रिटन. मैनी ऑफ दीज हैड टू बी रिटन आउट बाई हैंड. मैनी ऑफ दीज इम्पोर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट्स वर ऑल्सो रिटन बाई हैंड. ऑल्दो ही परफॉर्म्ड एन इनसिग्निफिकेंट फंक्शन दो हिज ड्यूटी द ड्यूटी ऑफ अशोका मित्रन वॉज नॉट सो इन्फ्लुएंशियल सो मच इफेक्टिव. He was the most well informed of all the members of the Gemini family. Asoka Mitran's job was not so much influential. Asoka Mitran ka jo kaam tha wo koi itna prabhavshali kaam nahi tha ki dusre ko prabhavit kar sake. He was the most well informed of all the members of the Gemini family. But he had got much famous, okay, among all the persons who worked at the Gemini studio. जेमिनी स्टूडियो में काम करने वाले सभी जितने भी सारे लोग थे उन सभी के बीच में वो सबसे ज्यादा एक जाना पहचाना व्यक्ति बन गया था. सबसे ज्यादा वहां पर जो है ना उसको इधर उधर से सूचनाएं मिला करती थी. सबसे ज्यादा सूचना प्राप्त करने वाला अच्छा एक व्यक्ति बन गया था. द फॉलोइंग इज एन एक्सेप्ट मीन्स पैसेज फ्रॉम हिज बुक माई ईयर्स विद बॉस. And the story which we are going to read at this moment, okay, is taken from his book, from Asoka Mitran's book, namely My Years with Boss. Okay, dear students, so now let's start reading the part of this, first part of this story. Here are different, set up by the author Asoka Mitran in different 3 to 4 parts. Though the parts are not clearly indicated, the story has not been divided into the part first, second, but I see that this is the story, okay, Poets and Pancakes has been written by the author Asoka Mitran in different 3 to 4 sections. And these the 3 to 4 sections are entirely based on different kinds of 3 to 4 incidents and 3 to 4 most important descriptions. In the first part of this chapter, in the first part of this lesson, of this story, we would learn something about the location, the exact location of the Gemini studio, the nature and behavior of the workers working at this studio, the different kinds of duties allocated and allotted to all the workers there at the studio, and some other such kinds of important things have been described by the author in the first section of this story. In the second section, we will be learning something about, but not something but a big detail. Sorry, a complete account of a person who worked in the story department at Gemini Studio, and his name was Kothmangalam Subbu. The author has covered around 2 pages while describing the features, while describing the things related to his nature, behavior and works. Okay. In so much extended part. In the third section, okay, the author has described and written in detail about the Moral Rearmament Army, whose founder was Frank Buchman, and he also writes so many things about this, the Moral Rearmament Army. In short, it is known as MRA, the MRA. And the last part, the poet describes the facts related to an English poet whose name is Stephen Spender, and some more interesting details which the author collects from library. And there are so many things which will surely help us know about the past days of before the independence, okay, and the nature and behavior of the people who worked there at the Gemini Studio also. So, Bete, first of all, we would like to get the meanings of these all important expressions. Okay. Hello, dear students, let's start getting the meanings of these all expressions. The word first word is here, believe over. The word believe over stands for here, okay, disappear gradually, faded, moved, move away. It is the second form of the word, blow over stands for here, disappear gradually, okay, or faint, get fainted. Catapult means here it works as a verb, shoot forth, shoot forth, shoot forth. So catapulted into, here I think the word meaning will be totally different, and its meaning would be, okay, hang, hang loosely or freely. Or we may also get the meaning of this word when we meet it in the story, like for fall himself or find himself or herself in a very typical or critical situation. Played into their hands, मतलब catapulted का मतलब ये होता है, catapulted का मतलब अपने आप को समस्या में फंसा लेना. Blow over का मतलब ये होता है धीरे धीरे कोई चीज अदृश्य होते चले जाना, खत्म होते चले जाना, ठीक है ना, उसके लिए आता है, समाप्त होते चले जाना. Played into their hands means worked as at the signal of others or worked as per the guidance of others. किसी दूसरे व्यक्ति के मुताबिक काम करना, दूसरे व्यक्ति की कठपुतली बन करके रहना, work as a puppet. Heard a bell ringing means the phone bell started jingling or ringing. Was stuck dumb and stands for be speechless. वहां जब भी ये वर्ड आएगा वहां पर बिल्कुल शांत हो जाना, कुछ नहीं बोलना. ओके, अ कोट ऑफ मेल स्टैंड्स फॉर अ प्रोटेक्टिव कोट के लिए आता है, जस्ट लाइक गाउन, जी ओ डब्ल्यू गाउन, गाउन मींस कोई एक लबादा जो होता है. द फेवरेट होम स्टैंड्स फॉर हियर द मोस्ट लाइक्ड प्लेस्ड. ओके, हार्टली लाइक्ड प्लेस्ड होता है, दिल से पसंद किया हुआ कोई स्थान, उसके लिए आता है फेवरेट होम. एंड इन अदर सेंस वी कैन ऑल्सो गेट इट मीनिंग द प्लेस वेयर ए पर्सन विजिट्स फ्रीक्वेंटली, उसको कहते हैं फेवरेट हॉन्ट, जिस जगह पर व्यक्ति बार बार आता जाता रहता है. ओके बेटा, लेट्स स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट पैसेज. Pancake was the brand name of the makeup material. The word pancake, which had been used by the author in this chapter right from the beginning till the end, okay, in almost all the parts. So the word pancake in those days was the name of a popular product stands for the brand of some makeup material. Stands for here the lotion or potion or some kind of liquid material, some kind of cream which was used to rub on the face, which was used to paste or put or slap on the face of some actors and actresses there, okay, in that film industry. So pancake was the brand name of the makeup material. Makeup material stands for the material which is used, okay, to decorate or to beautify the face. जिसको क्या कहते हैं, साज सज्जा का जो सामान होता है, श्रृंगार के सामान का एक बहुत ही सुप्रसिद्ध उत्पाद का नाम था पैनकेक. पैनकेक पुराने जमाने में, आजादी से पहले के समय के दौरान की बात है, पैनकेक एक श्रृंगार करने का एक बहुत उच्च कोटि का उत्पाद हुआ करता था, प्रोडक्ट हुआ करता था, जो लोग इस्तेमाल में लिया करते थे, जिसका अपने चेहरों को सुंदर बनाने के लिए इस प्रकार का एक लोशन, इस प्रकार की क्रीम का इस्तेमाल किया था, जिसका नाम था पैनकेक. दैट जेमिनी स्टूडियोज बॉट इन ट्रक लॉट्स ट्रांसफर बेटे इन मच अमाउंट. द जेमिनी स्टूडियो यूज टू बाई दैट द पॉपुलर दैट द फेमस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मेकअप मेटीरियल in much amount, in heavy amount, limitless amount, बहुत ज्यादा मात्रा में, जैसे कि मानो लदे हुए ट्रकों में, ट्रक लॉट्स का मतलब यहां पर जैसे कि मानो हम यूं कहेंगे भाई बहुत सारे ट्रकों में उस सामान को लाद लाद करके वहां पर जेमिनी स्टूडियो में मंगवाया जाता हो, भारी भरकम मात्रा में उस मेकअप मटेरियल का वहां पर खरीदारी की जाती हो, इस प्रकार से यहां पर सेंटर में बताया गया है कि पैनकेक एक साज सज्जा अर्थात श्रृंगार के सामान का एक उच्च कोटि का ब्रांड नेम था, नाम था, उत्पाद था, जिसकी जेमिनी स्टूडियो बहुत ज्यादा मात्रा में खरीदा करता था, जिसकी खरीदारी किया करता था. जेमिनी स्टूडियो के ऊपर पैनकेक की बहुत ज्यादा डिमांड रहती थी. जेमिनी स्टूडियो बॉट that the branded product of makeup material in much amount, heavy amount. Greta Garbo must have used it. It is estimated that Greta Garbo, who was a Swedish actress in the year of 1954, she received an honorary Oscar award. So that the Greta Garbo must have definitely used that the branded product of makeup material pancake, that the actress had also used pancake in her time, in her age. Miss Gohar must have used it. It is also estimated that Miss Gohar, who was also an Indian actress, must have used it. Vijayanti must have used it. Vijayanti Mala must have also used it. Vijayanti Mala, who was an Indian actress, must have surely used pancake. But Rati Agnihotri may not have even heard of it. But it is estimated that Rati Agnihotri, okay, might not have heard about the highly popularized product of makeup material. So कहा जाता है कि रति अग्निहोत्री ने शायद, हो सकता है कि पैनकेक नामक उस श्रृंगार के तौर पर काम में ले जाने वाले उस पदार्थ और उस चीज का, उस लोशन का, उस क्रीम का शायद उसने इस्तेमाल नहीं किया था और उसने कभी इसके बारे में सुना नहीं था. लेकिन इन तीन विशेष अभिनेत्रियों ने जरूर पैनकेक का इस्तेमाल किया था. किन किन ने किया था? ग्रेटा गैर्बो, ने निश्चित रूप से इसका इस्तेमाल किया होगा, मिस गौहड़ ने इसका निश्चित रूप से इस्तेमाल किया होगा और विजयंती माला ने भी इसका निश्चित रूप से इस्तेमाल किया होगा, लेकिन रति अग्निहोत्री ने शायद इसके बारे में नहीं सुना होगा ऐसा लगता है, सम्मान लगाया जाता है। द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द जेमिनी स्टूडियो वॉज इन द अपस्टेयर्स ऑफ ए बिल्डिंग। द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट नॉट द जेमिनी स्टूडियो बट द जेमिनी स्टूडियो द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट वॉज इंस्टॉल्ड वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड वॉज लोकेटेड एट द फर्स्ट फ्लोर इन द अपस्टेयर्स ट्रांसपेरियर मे बी एट द फर्स्ट फ्लोर और एट द सेकेंड फ्लोर। So here the name of the floor is not mentioned here, but it was not the makeup department of the Gemini studio was not located at the ground floor. It can be surely taken by us that the makeup department of the Gemini studio was located either at the first floor or at the second floor in the upstairs of a building. And the makeup department of the Gemini studio was located in the upstairs of the building that was believed to have been Robert Clive's stables. It was believed in those days also that the Robert Clive had also used the same building for sheltering his horses. The word stable stands for here, a place, a building where the horses or the cattle are sheltered. जिस जगह पर, जिस इमारत में, जिस जगह के ऊपर इस प्रकार से घोड़ों को रखा जाता है, बांधा जाता है, उस स्थान को क्या कहा जाता है? अस्तबल कहा जाता है हिंदी में। तो द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द जेमिनी स्टूडियो वाज इन द अपस्टेयर्स ऑफ ए बिल्डिंग, ऐसा कहा जाता है कि उस भवन के ऊपर वाले हिस्से में जेमिनी स्टूडियो का और श्रृंगार जो विभाग जो था वो वहां पर स्थित था, वहां पर बनाया हुआ था। जिस भवन का इस्तेमाल, जिस बिल्डिंग का इस्तेमाल, जिस इमारत का इस्तेमाल रॉबर्ट क्लाइव ने अपने घोड़ों के अस्तबल के रूप में कभी किया होगा, कभी किया था, ऐसा अनुमान लगाया जाता था। सो द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट और द मेकअप डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द जेमिनी स्टूडियो वाज लोकेटेड ओके इन द बिल्डिंग विच हैड बीन यूज्ड बाय रॉबर्ट क्लाइव फॉर सेल्टिंग हिज हॉर्सेज। ये एक्सप्लेनेशन इसकी बनती है। ए डजन अदर बिल्डिंग्स ओके इन द सिटी आर सेड टू हैव बीन हिज रेसिडेंस। इट इज ऑल्सो एस्टिमेटेड दैट apart from that building in which the makeup department of the Gemini studio was located, many more buildings had also been used by Robert Clive in the same city, Madras, Chennai. For his brief life and even briefer stay in Madras, since Robert Clive had not stayed in Madras for a long time, okay, Robert Clive seems to have done a lot of moving. It is also estimated that Robert Clive had moved there all around the city for a long time. Besides fighting some impossible battles in remote corners of India, Robert Clive had also showed his active participation in different kinds of impossible fights in different remote corners of India also, and marrying a maiden in St. Mary's Church in Fort Maiden's Transfer and married a girl in Fort St. George in Madras. And he had also, while staying in Madras, Robert Clive had also got himself married with a girl, okay, at St. Mary's Church in Fort St. George नामक किले के अंदर सेंट मेरी नामक गिरजाघर के अंदर उसने किसी एक लड़की से अपना विवाह भी किया था, वहां पर मद्रास शहर के अंदर रहते हुए। और कहता है कि मद्रास शहर में वो बीच बीच में आता जाता रहता था, उसका अपना एक अस्थायी निवास स्थल मद्रास शहर में बना हुआ था। हालांकि भारत के दूर दराज के लोग इलाकों में, दूर दराज के क्षेत्रों में वो एक असंभव लड़ाइयों में भी अपना एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन दिखाता था। वो बहुत असंभव प्रकार की लड़ाइयों को लड़ने के लिए वहां पर इधर उधर घूमता फिरता रहता, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी वहां पर वो मद्रास शहर में आता जाता रहता। तो इस प्रकार की बातें यहां पर कही गई हैं। बेटा द रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर विल बी अटेंडेड बाय अस इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर। थैंक यू।